السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
وعليكم السلام ورحمة الله وبركاته.
الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. اللهم علمنا ما ينفعنا، وانفعنا بما علمتنا، وزدنا علما، وألحقنا بعبادك الصالحين. رب اشرح لي صدري، ويسر لي أمري، واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي. في الليل إن شاء الله تفسير في سورة
الشمس.
استغفر.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. والشمس وضحاها، والقمر إذا تلاها، والنهار إذا جلاها، والليل إذا يغشاها، والسماء وما بناها، والأرض وما طحاها، ونفس وما سواها، فألهمها فجورها وتقواها، قد أفلح من زكاها، وقد خاب من دساها، كذبت ثمود بطغواها، إذ انبعث أشقاها، فقال لهم رسول الله ناقة الله وسقياها، فكذبوه فعقروها، فدمدم عليهم ربهم بذنبهم فسواها، ولا يخاف عقباها. والشمس وضحاها.
سورة الشمس مكية. As I mentioned before, I'll just repeat. In جزء عامة we have only three surah are مدنية. البينة، الزلزلة، النصر. Otherwise every surah is مكية. والشمس وضحاها. Same as the last surah, Allah سبحانه وتعالى made قسم. And this time with sun, shams. And as I said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when he made qasam, he made qasam by anything he decided, because he is the creator, everything is his creation. He can make qasam by anything he created. He is the king of kings, he is the owner. So anything belonging to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So we can make qasam with al-layl, duha, shams, al-adiyat, the horses, the war, whatever. Whatever he wants, he make qasam. وَضُحَاهَا to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make qasam by al-shams, which is the sun, and the light of this sun. And al-duha is the time during sunrise. So after sunrise, when the sun becomes on the height of one spear, and so one spear almost 2 meters or 1 meter and 80 cents, something like that. So if we can calculate by the time, after sunrise, after 10 minutes, exactly, this is the time of duha, until we can say maybe 11 cents, something like that. Up to the how fuqaha calculate the time of the duha, so it's not consistent. Okay, so that والشمس وضحاها والقمر إذا تلاها. قمر in Arabic is the moon. So الشمس is sun, القمر is moon. قمر إذا تلاها, so after sun rise until sunset, there is dark, نور, light. After that, until the half of the Arabic months, until the day of 15, the moon appeared directly after sun. But of course, it's delay, not directly. It means the night of 15, we go to Qamar al-Badr. Exactly after sun set, you will see the moon complete. Even before that, every time after sunset, you will see the moon even before that, before even sunset. After the night of 14 or 15, the moon will be complete. It will be parallel, like sunset and the moon. Then after next day, it will be 50 minutes later. 15 minutes later. So sunset, then after a few minutes, or 1 hour, or 2 hours, according to how many nights, you will see the moon. وَالْقَمَرِ إِذَا تَلَاهَا coming after the sun. So the first 15 days, the sun, the moon, set before sunset. But the time, sorry, not set before sunset. The time of sun, the moon when it rise, it's after the night of 14, when the sunset start to rise. It will be like moon, we call it Badr. Badr means complete. So before that, it's different time. So just 15 days. والقمر إذا تلاها. والنهار إذا جلاها. النهار is daytime. النهار is daytime. النهار إذا جلاها means after the night cover everything, the نور of the day cover this earth, make everything light. Then والليل إذا يغشاها. ليل is night. يغشاها means the darkness of الليل, night, cover also everything. So why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make present by these things? Ulama spoke about this point that after night, like at night time, people are almost not same, it's just metaphor. Like dead people, dead. We are sleeping, so no one moves, like people are sleeping. Life is not moving much at night time. Then from this status, dead, sun come, nahar come, daytime come, light spread everywhere, people start to again wake up and move, life start again. So dead and life. It's of course metaphor, not literal words. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala qasam that the time changing and situation also changing. You have sun, sunrise, sunset, moon, rise, set, daytime, light, moon, after moon, darkness. 15 nights, darkness. 15 nights, you have light from the moon. This is the explanation or description about life and death. Like time also always changing, the status of the people also changing. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as I mentioned, by everything He wants. But in everything Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mukassam, it's only important things. Think about sun. Can you live without sun? Impossible. Sun and moon is very important for the human being. Without sun and moon, we can't stay alive. Without nahar, daytime, you can't stay alive. You can't live all your life by night time. It's impossible for you. Same with all the opposite, like all night, daytime, and there is no night. You can't. Everything Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is very important. Even if it's fruits, you will find many, many benefits from that kind of fruits. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by some fruits, whatever He makes them, it's very good, not trivial things. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can make any qasam by anything, even though everything He makes qasam in Quran is very good. والليل إذا يغشى. Then continue.
والسماء وما بناها.
والسماء وما بناها. He also make qasam by السماء, but here علماء spoke about the حرف ما. والسماء وما بناها. ما it means من بناها. So man means who? Who? He made qasam by the creator of as-sama, the heaven. Okay, so ma in this verse means man. And man in Arabic means in English who. So the creator, I make qasam by the creator of as-sama, who is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This heaven he created by himself, so he made qasam by the creator of as-sama, which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
As-sama is?
Was-sama wa ma banaha. As-sama is the heaven. As-sama. Alaykum as-salam. Wal-ardi. Wal-ardi wa ma tuhaha. Al-ard, earth. Tuhaha, he made it like proper and life is available and possible on the earth. So it's not like this, no. We call it in Arabic musattaha, flat. Yeah, flat. So you can have your life easy. So the earth is not like this, you know, like something up, down, up, down. Life can't be. So, وَالْأَرْضُ وَمَا طَحَاهَا. Yes. He made it flat, he made it prepared for the life for human being. Because if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala didn't make the earth prepared for us, of course it's impossible that insan will be khalifa in earth, in this earth. That's why giving you another hint or another point that we are not qualified to live on any other planet except the earth. Although there are many planets, right? Can we live on any other planet? No. Although Earth is planet and other planets also is planets, right? But we live only on the Earth. Even if we have the ability to move from the Earth to another planet by nowadays technology, but we can't live our life in any other planet. Why? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala prepared Earth only. This verse. Earth only are available and prepared for us to live on it. Any other planet? No. وَنَفْسٍ وَمَا سَوَّهَا. He also made qasam with a nafs. I heard it. This verse, now it was about Allah. وَنَفْسٍ وَمَا سَوَّهَا. He speak about our like creation as a human. Our nafs and our body. And that he give us the mind, give us ability to know what is correct and what is not correct, to think, to have heart, to have feeling, all of these things, Allah subhanahu give it to us. وَنَفْسِ وَمَا سَوَّهَا. He continue, فَأَلْهَمَهَا فُجُورَهَا وَتَقْوَاهَا. He show us the true way and good way, he show us also the evil way. فَأَلْهَمَهَا فُجُورَهَا وَتَقْوَاهَا. He show you taqwa and he show you like the evil things. And you can see by your own eyes. You can realize by your mind which way is true. Tariq al-Haq, the way of Haq, the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or the way of Shaitan. The way of ta'a, worshiping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, obeying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the way of taqwa, or the way of committing sins and being away from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and worshiping idols or any other god except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. قَدْ أَفْلَحَ مَنْ زَكَّاهَا. The person who try his best to obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and to receive his commandments and implement it, قَدْ أَفْلَحَ مَنْ زَكَّاهَا, and make tazkiyah for his nafs. This person, insha'Allah, by the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he is qualified to receive the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and enter paradise by the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, not by his deeds. قَدْ أَفْلَحَ مَنْ زَكَّاهَا. Opposite meaning, وَقَدْ خَابَ مَنْ دَسَّاهَا. Next verse. Opposite. So the person who will not obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who will not protect the commandment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and implement it, and always commit sins, and not even believing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, not making tazkiyah for his nafs, he would be loser in the hereafter. فَالْخَابَ مَنْ دَسَّهَا. Then the surah turned to speak about real story. That real story happened at the time of Sayyidina Salih alayhi salam. And his people are Thamud. قوم ثمود كذبت ثمود بطغواها عليهم السلام. قوم ثمود are Arab people by the way. قوم عاد and قوم ثمود Arab people. Even the قوم of سيدنا شعيب عليه السلام Arab people. We're in Yemen. اليمن is the roots of all Arabs. اليمن is the roots of all Arabs. يمن 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 is the roots of all Arabs.
يمن is Houthis are attacking the ships in the Red Sea.
Yeah. So Yemen is the roots of Arabs. Even Sayyidina Ismail alayhi salam, he didn't become Arab except when Bani Jurhum, when they left Yemen after the Sad Ma'rib has been destroyed, they migrated until they reached Mecca. And they didn't want to actually to live there because they just they are moving to like search for water. Then they saw the birds gathering. It was about Zamzam. Then they asked permission from Sayyid Hajar alayhi salam if we can live next to you because of the water of Zamzam. Those Bani Jurhum are Arab people. Alaykum salam. So those Bani Jurhum are Arab people. Came from where? From Yemen. So from that time, Sayyidina Ismail grew up with them and he started to speak in Arabic. That's why we call Sayyidina Ismail alayhi salam from Al-Arab Al-Musta'riba. He became Arab. He wasn't Arab, he became Arab. Okay? So, Qawm Thamud from Arab. Their Prophet Sayyidina Salih alayhi salam. He came after Sayyidina Hud. Sayyidina Hud first. وَإِلَىٰ عَادٍ أَخَاهُمْ هُودًا. قوم عاد first. Their Prophet Sayyidina Hud عليه السلام. Arabs, Yemen. Then later, Sayyidina Salih عليه السلام, his people are قوم ثمود. كَذَّبَتْ ثَمُودُ بِطَغْوَاهَا. They disbelieved in Sayyidina Salih alayhi salam and they went against him. Why they did? And even they didn't believe in the miracle Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent to him. What's that miracle and why? By short, I will not explain much because it's, it should be in Qasas al-Anbiya, in another separate knowledge. So I'll just give hint or summarization. When Sayyidina Salih alayhi salam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent him to Thamud, those people, they didn't want to believe unless he showed them big miracle. Then he said, what kind of miracle you want? They asked him something, you know, it's impossible. He said, you look at that mountain, he said, yes. You look at this rocks, the mountain like built from rocks and stones. You see this big rock from inside the mountain, he said, yes. Ask your Allah to create big camel. From that rock. Not only that, that camel are pregnant. You can imagine what they ask. Camel from the rock and pregnant. So no husband, you know, you can imagine no husband for this camel. No, no. Camel and pregnant. Ask your God, ask your Allah if you are through a prophet, ask him to create this thing. And must be very big. He made dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepted his dua because he's a prophet. All of them watch by their eyes. From the big rock in the mountain, split, and the camel came out. Big camel. Came out and they saw by their eye. Then he said to them, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordered you to not slaughter this camel. Never, never touch this camel. One day, you have your day to bring the water from the well, and one day for that camel. Okay, no problem. After a few days or some time, they made a plan to slaughter this camel. كذبت ثمود بطغواها إذ انبعث أشقاها. أشقاها, he was one person. عمر نمر his name. His name is that guy. قدار. Do you remember his name? His name is something like Qudar. I don't remember much about the name of that guy, because his name is mentioned in Tafsir Ibn Kathir. Tafsir Ibn Kathir, he mentioned his name. Got his point? Got his name? His name was what? In mission Tafsir Ibn Kathir. You just write the name of the person who killed the camel.
Who I know him? Who?
الشخص اللي ذبح الناقة سيدنا صالح. Is this Qudar or something like that? I'm not sure about the name. Got it, Omar?
Qudar,
huh? Something like that. Got it? No one? تفسير ابن كثير. سيدنا صالح عليه السلام. فقد اكتب الشخص الذي ذبح الناقة, ذبح ناقة سيدنا صالح. اسمه. عمر بيبس.
مصدق.
اسمه؟
مصدق.
لا 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 أعطينا هذا ال
مصدع بن ده.
لا 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 قدار بن سالف. يس هذا المشهد قدار بن سالف. This person is, he is the person who قدار as I mentioned. قدار مثل as I
mentioned. مصدق
بن دار. دول تحالفوا, لكن الشخص اللي ذبح الناقة هو واحد بس.
قدار.
So as I mentioned, okay, stop searching. Stop. As I mentioned, his name is قدار, and his name mentioned in تفسير الإمام الحافظ ابن كثير. Yes.
قدار ابن سليم.
ابن سالف.
سالف.
قدار بن سالف. So كذبت ثمود وطغواها إذ انبعث أشقاها. أشقاها means that person. قدار بن سالف. He was one of the biggest rank and highest rank among his people. But in the same time he was the worst regarding to akhlaq and manners and evilness. So that person, they asked him to slaughter that camel, and they made like alliance, like group to slaughter that camel. Actually, they were, I think, 9 people or 7 or 9 people. They agreed upon slaughtering this camel. فقال لهم رسول الله ناقة الله وسقياها. سيدنا صلاح عليه السلام told them that you have your day and this camel had its own day to drink the water and these things. No one come at the day of the camel and the camel will never come to your day. You take your time, the camel also will take its time. فكذبوه فعقروها. They didn't listen to that prophet, Sayyidina Salih alayhi salam. Because in other surah, قال يا قوم هذه ناقة الله لكم آية فذروها تأكل في أرض الله ولا تمسوها بسوء فأخذكم عذاب كريم. Don't touch that camel. Let it eat and drink. Don't touch it by any harmful thing or slaughtering that camel or Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will punish you. The Sayyidina Salih alayhi salam give it clear to them. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will punish you if you did something harmful to that camel. Until now it's fine, right? This is another surah. Go back to Surah Al-Shams. فَكَذَّبُوهُ فَعَقَرُوهُ. They didn't believe in the message of Sayyidina Salih alayhi salam. Why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent that camel? And the daughter of that camel? Why? Why? To believe in him, to believe that he is a messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Right? This is actually the main purpose of any miracle coming by any prophet, especially Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, to make people believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to make people believe that that person is a prophet, because no one can do that such thing like that except a person who are supported by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Otherwise, anyone can claim that he's a prophet. I can claim, you can claim, anyone can claim. Right? But how people can believe if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala show a miracle on your hands? Then you say, yes, this person is a prophet because we saw something, it's a miracle. It's impossible. So he said, okay, you asked for that miracle. Allah subhanahu give it to you already. Now, don't touch that camel. Ever. When that camel eats, when that camel drink, don't touch it. You eat, like, let your animals eat in the proper day, and all of you drink in the proper day. فَكَذَّبُوهُ فَعَقَرُوهُ. They called Qudar ibn Salif and other people. They are like mafia, you can say mafia. And they agreed upon slaughtering that camel. And then they slaughtered that camel. فَلَمْدَمْ عَلَيْهِمْ رَبُّهُمْ بِذَنْبِهِمْ فَسَوَّاهَا وَلَا يَخَافُ عُقُوبَهَا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala punished them all. But you say, Shaykh, the people who slaughtered that camel, who made a plan, are 9 or 7. And the person who slaughtered that camel must be one. The person who holds a knife must be one. So why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala didn't punish those 9 or 7 people only, and punish the whole city, the all come hood, all come Thamud? Why all of them has been punished? Why the people only who made that mistake didn't be punished, and the punishment cover all of them, all of the people? Why? Because they agreed upon that. The warning came to everyone. Don't touch that camel. But they called those mafias, those people, they. And they agree and give the green light. Give the green light to slaughter that camel. Yes, they didn't do anything except that, but just giving the green light, agree upon something like that, going against the commandments of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the commandment of His Messenger, this enough to receive a punishment. Actually, their crime same as those who slaughtered the camel. Same. The people who committed that crime and the people who agreed upon that, same rank. And this is giving you a big sign in our life now. So if we call it an-nahy al-munkar, means what? من رأى منكم منكرا فليغيره بيده فإن لم يستطع فبلسانه فلا من صدق فبقلبه وذلك اضعف الايمان. This is حديث عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. Right? So if you see some munkar, if you can change it by your hands, by yourself, it's okay. But if not available, then by your tongue, give advice. This is haram, this is munkar. If even your tongue, if you speak by your tongue, it will be dangerous. At least you deny by your heart. What these people did? They spoke by their tongue, encouraged the other people to slaughter the camel, and their heart also support them. So tongue and heart support. And those people started by their hands. So the three pillars of munkar already has been approved and fulfilled. Some people by their hands, and the other people by their tongue and their heart. That's why the punishment for all of them. فَلَمْدَمَ عَلَيْهِمْ رَبُّهُمْ بِذَنْبِهِمْ فَسَوَّاهُمْ وَلَا يَخَافُ عُقْبَاهُمْ. Their punishment was very cruel, but of course they deserve, because Allah SWT gave a chance many times. They ask for miracle, they give them miracle. Actually, after the people ask for miracle by themselves, either they will believe or they will receive punishment directly. Because from the beginning, he spoke with them normally. He said, believe in Allah, I'm a messenger of Allah, fine. Right? But they didn't say no. They try to argue and give high level challenge. From that mountain, from that big rock, ask your Allah to create camel, pregnant.
It's strange they didn't believe even after the camel was created.
Yeah, that's why the people of Sayyidina Isa alayhi salam, who asked Sayyidina Isa alayhi salam to make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bring them ma'ida, big like table of food. Big, very big from as-sama, from the heaven. He said, if you're going to believe it will be horrible after that. He said, no. If you bring that big ma'ida from as-sama, from the heaven, we will believe in you. Miracle happened. They asked for miracle, and the miracle happened. The ma'ida came, all of them ate from it, but all of them disbelieved in Sayyidina Isa alayhi salam and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What happened? Change it to swine. Swine?
Swine.
Swine. Yeah, swine. Pigs then. Pigs, yeah. It's not easy. The only people Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives them many chances even after asking for miracles, come Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. When they asked him to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to spread the moon, he said, you are asking for miracle. Say yes, if you could split the moon, we will believe in you. Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam made dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Ya Allah, please split the moon. And the moon has been split two parts. Every part on the top of the mountain. Of course not on the top of the moon. Like, you can see by your eyes, it looks like that. Two parts, two separate parts like this. What he said, you are a big magician. They didn't even believe in Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Even though they took some more chances. Even though some of those people has been punished at the Battle of Badr. Their punishment has been fulfilled at the Battle of Badr, has been killed. Those people. Starting with Abu Jahl. Battle of Badr has been killed. Utbah ibn Shaybah and his brother, yes, there are two, like Utbah, I think or maybe Rabia or something like that, has been killed, and 70, one of those mushrikeen, among them masters of Quraysh, has been killed in battle of Badr, punishment. Even Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, before the battle happened, that Abu Jahl would be killed in this place. Not only he would be killed in this place, and that person in this place, and that person in that place. And Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told the Sahaba that Abu Jahl would be killed in this place before the battle started. You can imagine? Before the battle started, he would be killed in this place, and that person in that place, and that person in that place. Punishment. from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to his people. So our prophets, may Allah peace be upon all of them, their people always will agree with them. So whenever any prophet come by da'wah, by oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, don't worship idols, be good with your parents, and people oppose them and become enemies of them and try to attack them and even kill them. That happened from Sayyidina Nuh alayhi salam until Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi salam, and still happening for the most famous people who are giving da'wah. They are not feeling free actually. Some enemies from here and there, some reason that you will be killed. Many things happening, especially in other countries. Here, alhamdulillah, is a very peaceful country, but in other countries, you will see many disaster happening. Demolishing their image, their family, threatening, kidnapping, many things happening. And we heard about many dua and scholars has been killed already. They are giving lecture on some gun or whatever, sniper. Many things happening, especially in Western countries. These things unfortunately happened. So the way of da'wah is not easy. It's one of the biggest and most difficult. And our scholars and Al-Azhar said, the way of da'wah not full of flowers. You will only find troubles and challenges and tests from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The more the person are more rituals, close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the more he is trying to convey the message of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the more he will find many tests from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but the results you can't even imagine. Inshallah. Qul qawli hadha wa astaghfirullah li wa lakum. Wa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam wa barakatuh wa sallam wa alayhi 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 wa sallam